To be successful in any endeavor, you need clarity and focus. Focus is critical in designing your brand identity. My name is Catherine Gaho, and I've spent many years as a trainer, researcher, and entrepreneur in the field of marketing. I've trained thousands of people on marketing and brand strategy. One of the questions that I've been asked many times is, how do you create a compelling brand identity for a business? This is a common question from many people, and many times I find that people confuse brand identity with brand image. Brand identity gives a picture of what you want your brand to stand for. What do you want it to represent? Well, brand image is how it actually is currently perceived in the marketplace. Brand identity provides clarity on how the brand wants to be known and its general outlook. It articulates what the brand stands for and what values it seeks to project from the marketer's perspective. It indicates the unique set of associations which you want to express or uphold. This helps in designing effective communication for the brand. Think about it. If you do not have a clear brand identity, if it's not clear to you what you want to represent, how would you be able to design communication that clearly helps your customer understand your brand? We're going to look at six elements of brand identity at this point. First, you begin by focusing on your product. You need to clearly define your product or service. State in writing the specific attributes and values and quality features that you want to deliver. It's kind of a promise to yourself that you then can make to the market. Once it's totally clear to you, then you can be able to deliver it for your customers. Secondly, you need to define the usage of the product or service. What does it do? What is it for? More specifically, what problem will it solve for the customer? The only way to receive any money from anyone is to meet a want or need, is to solve a problem, is to have a product or service that meets the need of the customer better than whatever else is available in their sphere of life. You need to provide real value for people to be willing to part with their money. Thirdly, you have to define the intended users. Who will use the product? Who is it for? If you are not very clear on who you are intending to serve, it's very difficult to create outstanding value. Sometimes I've asked people who are starting a new business, who is your customer? Who's going to be your customer? Who are you going to serve? And they quickly answer, everyone. And I'm left at a loss. How can it be realistic that you will serve everyone? Because the market for any item is made up of diverse consumer groups, and they want different benefits, different value, different propositions. Think about it. When you go to buy a phone, how many options are you presented with? When you want to buy even basic things like cheese, burger, pizzas. In fact, many times they even say, make your own pizza. So you go and say, add some cheese, bring mozzarella and the like. Creating your own product, it's a way of responding to the question of meeting the specific need for a specific target. Fourth, it's important to define the product's origin, the country of source. This is very simple, but it has serious implications in marketing. We say made in Kenya or made in Switzerland, and that is an expression of brand identity. The brand has a home. People want to know, customers want to know, what is the home of this brand? Where does it come from? It has to come from somewhere. And many times, customers associate the brand with the values and the culture of the people of its home country. Think of Swiss watches and the association of precision. Every time we think of a country, there is a product we associate them with. Think of the flowers, the beautiful flowers from the land of Kenya. made in Kenya. We say, made in Kenya. Kenya is associated with flowers and Masai Mara, the seventh wonder of the world. Think about how the flowers from Kenya are harvested, packaged lovingly, and air freighted daily to global destinations so that they can adorn the tables of so many hotels, so many offices, so many homes. Also that they can be used to celebrate a great event or even serenade a loved one. Flowers from Kenya grace events, they grace weddings and even funerals all over the world, with greatest demand being around Valentine's, because that's a day people celebrate love. That's how a source or origin of a product can have power. It says something about the product. The fifth item to consider is brand personality. I love to talk about brand personality. You need to define clearly the personality that you want the brand to have. Brands have human-like characteristics. This should not be left to chance. It should be something that you have control over. What do you want people to identify and associate this brand with in terms of personality? This is an important aspect of brand identity. You need to determine if you want a brand to represent warmth, kindness, friendliness, or you want it to be sophisticated and high class, or would you prefer for it to be just dependable and loyal? In fact, many times in my research business, when we do brand personality research, where we test for companies the representation of their brand to their consumers, particularly the loyal consumers, they'll be able to associate it and tell whether they see it as male or female. It can be seen to be young, single, and free to mingle, while another brand can be seen as family-oriented or married with children. A brand represents the ethos of a hustler or dynasty. As some in Kenya would say, some brands that I've worked for are viewed as caring and family-oriented, while others from their competitors are viewed as strong, efficient, and aggressive. Both deliver the service, both are successful, but each has its own target, serves in a different style, meeting a different target market expectations. Think of brands like cars. Which cars do you think have a feminine feel? Which brands of cars do you think have a masculine feel? The next one is brand consumer relationship. What is the nature of the relationship you want your brand to have with its customers? In creating brand identity, you must make all these decisions. You must make the decision on the relationship. As I've said many times, relationships are what makes a business, not transactions. So defining the consumer brand relationship is coming out to clearly spell out what you desire to be the nature of the interaction between the brand and its consumer. How are they going to interact? How are they going to relate? A brand can appear to know the customer or understand them well, or it can appear to make them feel anonymous. It can make them feel valued, like VIPs, or taken for granted. It can make them feel confident or insecure. Think about the airlines and the hotels that you have used. The relationship element of brand identity is more noticeable in the hospitality industry. And as you have heard it said, people care more about how you make them feel. So make sure that your brand makes your customer feel special, feel important, feel worthy and valued, and the money will definitely follow. Thank you for watching this video. If you find this material useful, press the subscriber button on your screen right now and like it as well. Before I close, I have a question for you. What action will you take in the next few days to understand and clarify your brand identity? Start by one step only, and you will build momentum to reach where you want to go. All the best. Thank you very much.